One thing that is important to note here, though, is that the result of the addition might require one more bit than the operands. So this is what the textbook is trying to illustrate with the diagrams that look like this. So on one axis, we have the first operand, which is from 0 up to 15. And then on the other axis, we have the second operand, so 0 up to 15. But you'll notice that the result axis, so the sort of the zero, the z axis, or the vertical axis here, is 32. The maximum value is 32, which is sort of, well, 15 plus 15 is 30. So we don't quite get up to 32, but we get certainly higher than 16. And so this is, you know, double the value of the two inputs, which makes sense. So if we have the two highest inputs, we're going to get a number that is roughly double that number. And so it's worth thinking a little bit about what will happen here if we take the result of this addition, so all of these bars, and we try to fit the result back into the same sized integer as the operands were stored in. So here, for example, there were 4-bit inputs, and we got a 5-bit output. So what happens if we try to take the outputs and store them back into a 4-bit result field? And hopefully you can see that what would happen is exactly the sort of thing that we talked about last time, which is overflow. So if you can imagine taking a knife and kind of cutting through the vertical plane here at 16, some of these bars would get sort of chopped off. And in fact, if you're doing this in addition, what would happen is that they would kind of wrap around. And so you'd get some numbers where you'd have the correct answer, and then you'd have some numbers where you would overflow and you would get the wrong answer. So here's one example. So we have this number here and this number here. So these are much larger numbers. These aren't 4-bit numbers. These are 2-byte numbers. But we add them together. We end up with a carry into the next digit. And that has to get truncated if we're going to save it back into the same field. And so we end up with a number that really should be much larger, but instead it's smaller. So if we think about this with respect to 2's complement, we actually have the capability for this to happen on both ends of the number line. So it's subject to both positive and negative overflow. These are the results for which the answer is correct, and then we have, you know, negative overflow, and we also have positive overflow. So negative overflow is when we were supposed to get a negative number and we got a positive number. Positive overflow is when we were supposed to have a positive number but we overflowed and now we have a negative number. It's important to notice here that in some editions of the textbook, this diagram is actually printed incorrectly. So this is the correct one from the textbook's website. And this is something to keep in mind as you're working in C, to keep your eye out for places here. So again, there are a lot of numbers for which the answer is correct, but you do need to be aware of sort of these edge cases where if you're working with very large numbers or very small numbers, or positive and negative numbers, there are potential interactions where the number will overflow and you'll get the incorrect answer. This works itself out in some weird and unexpected ways. One way that I encountered at one point I ran into online is in the game Magic the Gathering, actually. I don't play Magic myself, but I found this extremely fascinating. So there's this card, and the details aren't terribly important, but I included them for those of you who would appreciate the details here. But basically the idea is that through a combination of this particular card's abilities, you can end up doubling a player's life every few turns. And again, this would never happen in a real competitive environment, right? Because this requires your opponent to be cooperating and allowing you to do this. But it is theoretically possible. And if you're doubling your value every time, what that essentially means is that eventually you're going to overflow. So there's a nice video here that I'll link below this video, where you can watch a player actually exploiting this in the MTG game, where they actually get this going and they do it for long enough that they actually are able to overflow the player's life because it's stored as a signed 32-bit integer. And so this is a problem, you know, that manifests itself in strange and possibly unexpected ways. I've also heard stories about this. So there was at one point YouTube was storing their view counts using a signed number, and there was a particularly popular video that overflowed that signed integer, and they had to sort of switch the way that they stored view counts because of that video.